here's something we hope you'll really like.
These are South Asian rhesus monkeys. But this isn't Thailand. We're in Central Florida, about 1 hour from Orlando.
I'm really not aware of anywhere else you can go and see monkeys in what seems like a wild.
That's because these guys are Asian immigrants. The Sunshine State is one of the few places in the country to see them. In this neck of the woods, a renegade clan of rhesus monkeys has taken over the shores of the Silver River.
There was probably a troop of 20 to 25 swinging from tree to tree. It was like being in a Tarzan movie.
Funny you should say that. These monkeys are here due to one man with a scheme inspired by the silver screen.
Well, the monkeys have been here since the late 1930s. They were brought in by Colonel Captain Toohey.
Captain Toohey ran a jungle cruise on this very river. After the 1932 hit Tarzan the Ape Man inspired a slew of sequels, he saw a surefire way to boost ticket sales. Toohey knew folks couldn't resist seeing an island teeming with exotic wild monkeys.
Colonel Toohey brought the monkeys down here, then released them on the island.
And he couldn't resist the sight of dollar signs, even at the expense of the rhesus monkey. But there was one thing he didn't count on.
They probably weren't there more than a half hour and they swam off the island.
What Captain Toohey didn't know was that rhesus monkeys can swim at 2 days old. What were you doing at 2 days? Exactly. Rhesus monkeys can live anywhere. Swamps, mountains, deserts, even cities. If there's food to be found, these monkeys will thrive. By the mid-70s, 6 monkeys had turned to 80. How many today? No one really knows. And some folks in Florida aren't so happy about this monkey invasion. Today, they wander the state at will, with sightings as far as 100 miles away from the Silver River.
You don't introduce new species to an area. Sometimes they have a negative impact on the ecosystem.
So don't monkey around, and get here soon in case these primates are sent packing.
Progress came and took its toll, and in the name of flood control, they made their plans and they drained the land. Now the glades are going dry. And the last time I walked in the swamp, I sat up on a cypress stump. I listened close and I heard the ghost of Osceola cry. Blow, Seminole wind, blow like you're never gonna blow. gone. Since the days of old, men would search for wealth untold. They dig for silver and for gold, and leave the empty holes. And way down south in the Everglades, where the black water rolls and the sawgrass waves, the eagles fly and the otters play in the land of the Seminoles. So blow, blow, Seminole wind, blow like you're never gonna blow again. I'm calling to you like a long lost friend, but I know who you are. And blow, blow from the Okeechobee all the way up to Micanopy. Blow across the home of the Seminoles, the alligators and the gars. Progress came and took its toll, and in the name of flood control, they made their plans and they drained the land. Now the glades are going dry. And the last time I walked in the swamp, I sat up on a cypress stump. I listened close and I heard the ghost of Osceola cry.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ashley Glass.
And I'm Laura Harris. And here is the proof for ourselves. We got to see it from Action Air One. Yes, those are all gators. All of this in Myakka State Park. It's attracting this unusually large size of all these gators, Ashley.
It is startling to look at here. The NAS Nicole Grigg with the unusual way we found out about this. And why here?
Hidden away behind a locked gate in a secluded area of Sarasota, Florida Park Ranger Terrence Torvin takes us to an area so secretive, most people didn't even know it existed.
Yeah.
To get here, you usually have to walk 2 miles. But we took a truck through tough terrain. After about a 10-minute drive, we got to the area known as Deep Hole at Myakka River State Park. And instantly, we see alligator after alligator in this 130-foot deep sinkhole. With Terrence close by our side, we walk through knee-high dry prairie, giant oak trees and branches with sharp needles for a better view.
Palm log to watch out for.
Eventually, we got here, finding proof of endless gators. Today, there were about 100.
This is an amazing place.
We went searching for the gators after these pictures from professional European photographer Lee Dalton went viral this week. The pictures are from 2014, but were recently published in a French magazine. We talked to him in Europe by Skype.
And that particular year, there were a few more alligators than your typical year, just because there are so many dead fish for them to eat.
Here's why Deep Hole is such a secret. Only 30 people a day can get a free permit to go to this location. You can either walk or go by kayak.
I kind of like the 30 people a day limit.
These women got lucky nabbing a permit.
Just nice to be able to sit and watch them in their natural habitat.
You'll only see these gators gathering like this just after the first of the year, when the water is colder and the sun is out.
Usually they run away from you when you get close.
It's a beautiful reminder of the wildlife and danger that's all around us in Florida. For the now, I'm Nicole Grigg.